वनकम, मैं हैदर अली सैयद आशीर्वाद से यूनाइटेड अंडर तमिल सेवा।
रमजान स्पेशल। रमजान अ मंथ डेडिकेटेड टू अंडरस्टैंड कुरान। रमजान अ मंथ डेडिकेटेड टू शॉर्ट नमाज बेस्ड ऑन बुराक हदीस। रमजान अ मंथ व्हेन अ बिजनेसमैन गिव्स ज़कात टू वेरियस मदरसास विच क्रिएट मौलवीज मुफ्ती हाफिज आलिम so that they can lead people in doing short namaz based on Burak Hadith. They say, short namaz based on Burak Hadith is a gift from Miraj. Did you know that standing behind an elected minister, Khalifa, and taking part in active government is Islam? Did you know Burak Hadith of Bukhari goes against Quran? Which means standing behind Maulana performing short salah based on Burak Hadith, which goes against Quran, is an innovation. Every innovation is un-Islamic. The concept of short salah and standing behind Maulana are innovation as it goes against Quran. Secondly, who are the rulers of Muslim world by DNA? Who introduced Shia, Sunni, Sufi, Wahhabi and other priestly cults among black natives of South Asia and across globe? By race and tribe, Muslim world is being ruled by Aryan settlers, the Romans and the Persians, who now are hiding behind Muslim label. Did you know? Persian Aryan settlers made policies to end the Asivagam principle of native blacks. Remember, Prophet Jesus and Prophet Muhammad never entertained Gentiles Aryan settlers. Who are Aryans? Aryans are children of Cain, who was cursed and banished from cradle of civilization. First Antichrist was Cain. Coming of Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal and its one-eyed system was introduced by Persian Aryan settlers. Varna Dharam was introduced by Persian Aryans. Term Hindu was given by Persian Aryans. Brahmanism or priestly cult introduced by Persian Aryans. The art of destroying truth, hiding native history and suppressing the black natives is well mastered by Aryan settlers. Remember, Bukhari is a man from Bukhara, a Persian Empire province. Bukhari, an Aryan. Let's expose Bukhari Hadith, whose authors are Persian Aryans. I read, narrated Malik bin Sasa, the Prophet said, while I was at the house in the state midway between sleep and awakeness, an angel recognized me as a man lying between two men. Here, lying between two men is an indication of cave culture which Persian Aryans Bukhari has wrote. I read Bukhari Hadith of Persian Aryans. It further says, a golden tray full of wisdom and belief was brought to me and my body was cut open from the throat to lower part of the abdomen. Remember, Aryan settlers in their Hadith book twice they wrote regarding Prophet Muhammad's chest being opened and his organs washed and cleaned with Zamzam water twice. Once when Prophet Muhammad was a boy and the other time during Miraj by Burak. Remember, Prophet Muhammad or Prophet Jesus never entertained Aryan settlers or Gentiles who are from heedless nation of Cain. Anyway, let's still expose the lie of Aryan settlers with the help of Quran so that the common people can understand and know the fact. Here, we just want to make the point clear that those who accept this Burak Hadith perform short salah. They together with Aryan settlers are making mockery of Prophet Muhammad, mockery of Quran, mockery of Allah and the way of life, Asivagam, which Allah taught by pen to the first Siddha, Tamil Shiva Alai Seth. Remember, under Asivagam, which teaches us to stand behind elected minister, Khalifa and common people should take active part in administration by getting involved in policy making. With this, thus establishing equality between elites and common people are maintained. Quran, which is the final reminder for Asivagam, talks about Day of Jummah. Jummah, a day behind elected minister, where common people get their problem solved. Standing behind Maulana, priestly cult, on the Day of Jummah is an innovation, an un-Islamic act designed to protect Varna Dharam. Standing behind Maulana and performing short salah based on Burak Hadith, which goes against Quran, is a double mistake done by so-called Muslims who are blindly following Aryan settlers' cult. Short namaz, which you say is a gift from Miraj, is based on Burak Hadith. Remember, that gift is not a gift really. because Burak Hadith is fake and it goes against Quran. Let's expose Bukhari Burak Hadith with the help of Quran. I read further, and then my abdomen was washed with Zamzam water and my heart was filled with wisdom and belief. Cutting open the chest and cleaning organs with water Zamzam and then pouring wisdom into heart. Is this the way that Allah gives wisdom to His messengers? Remember, when we read the biography of all messengers, we find that all prophets sat in seclusion and meditated, including Maryam, mother of Jesus. Ancient tradition of Asivagam, which all prophets, including Prophet Muhammad, followed. Quran talks about Kundalini chakra. Quran chapter 15 verse 87 says about 7 of repeating chakras. I read, and we have certainly given you, O Muhammad, 7 of the often repeated and the great Quran. There are many verses in Quran that talks about wisdom, but nowhere in says such thing as cutting open chest and cleaning organs with water Zamzam and pouring wisdom into heart. Again, we have proven Burak Hadith as fake. So there is no question of short salah and standing behind Maulana and funding madrasas. Anyway, let's read the Burak Hadith of Persian Aryan Bukhari with shortened yoga asana of Asivagam further. Burak Hadith says, I read, Al Burak, a white animal, smaller than a mule and bigger than a donkey, was brought to me. Remember, you all must have read the story of Queen Sheba and King Solomon. I read the story from Quran, chapter 27, verse 38. Solomon said, O assembly of jinn, which of you will bring me Queen Sheba throne before they come to me in a submission? A powerful one from among the jinn said, I will bring it to you before you rise from your throne. And indeed, I am this stronger and trustworthy, said one who had knowledge from the scriptures. I will bring it to you before your glance returns to you. Remember, Queen Sheba is from Ethiopia, while King Solomon was at Jerusalem. Jinn, demon, said, we can bring Queen Sheba throne before King Solomon rises from his place. While a knowledgeable man, a scientist, said he can bring the throne before King Solomon's glance can return back to him. Here in Burak Hadith, Angel Gabriel is taking help of a donkey, mule, to carry Prophet Muhammad from Mecca to Jerusalem. Remember, as per other hadith, that Burak at first refused to let Prophet Muhammad mount on it. Thus, that donkey insulting Angel Gabriel and Prophet Muhammad. Such are the Aryan settlers Bukhari hadith. Based on such fake Burak hadith, you so-called Muslim performing short namaz. Remember, your short salah namaz does not benefit you. It only benefits priestly cult, who are the spies of Varnadharam. Thus, we will find no equality in society. Yoga meditation helps in activation of Kundalini chakra and connecting to higher conscience. Remember, standing behind priestly caste is not the teaching of Asivagam, other word Islam. One has to stand behind elected minister when common people are called to take part in active policy making in administration. Today, all the governments of the world are puppet government, as they are influenced by the syndicate of global elites under New World Order headed by Saudi. Their agenda, one world, one government, one religion. Remember, New World Order is 100% implementation of Varnadharam principles, Manu, Brahmanism, and implementation of cave culture of gay, lesbian, animal sex, child sex, exploitation of labor and women in all countries under Aryavarta. Aryavarta means complete eradication of Islam, and in other words, Asivagam. Performing short namaz based on fake Burak Hadith and standing behind Maulana is all un-Islamic. Remember, priestly cult were introduced by Aryan settlers as they had made Koil, which is the house of king, into idol avatar temple, thus protecting Varnadharam to suppress the common people, exploiting women by syndicate of elites. Remember, Jumma a day behind elected minister. Then why are you people, in spite of having Quran, stand behind a priest, a Maulana? Burak Hadith further says at various heaven, Prophet met many prophets. Here again, Burak Hadith statement goes against Quran chapter 23 verse 99 to verse 104, which talks about ancestral plane, Alam-e-Barzakh, and Quran chapter 7 verse 172 to 174, which talks about Alam-e-Arba. Quran chapter 23 verse 99 to 104, I read, until when death comes to one of them, he says, my Lord, send me back, that I might do righteousness in that which I left behind. No, it is only the word he is saying, and behind them is a barrier until the day of resurrection. So when the horn is blown, no relationship will there be among them that day, nor will they ask about one another. And those whose scales are heavy, it is they who are successful. But those whose scales are light, those are the ones who have lost their soul in hell, abiding there eternally. The fire will share their face, and they therein have a torn smile. Remember, Quran clearly says that all dead people's soul is kept in the ancestral plane, in other words, Alam-e-Barzakh. And on day of judgment, everyone would be judged. So how can Prophet Muhammad meet various prophets and spoke to them? And in other hadith says, Prophet Muhammad saw many people in hell and few people in heaven. When Quran clearly says that only after day of judgment, all mankind, jinn, faith would be judged, so fear that day. Finally, Burak hadith says that Prophet Muhammad met Prophet Moses, and 50 time namaz was shortened, and Prophet Muhammad brought short namaz based on Burak hadith of Persian Aryan Bukhari, and it says it's a gift from Miraj. Thus fooling people and protecting the Varnadharam policy of settlers, thus maintaining priestly cult of Brahminism. Here I want to make clear that Quran chapter 36 verse 1 to 11 clearly stops Prophet Muhammad from wasting time on cursed heedless people whose forefathers had no warning. Remember, Roman, Persian, Aryan settlers are now hiding behind Muslim label, and they have no authority to enter Hijaz region. Nor these cursed DNA have any authority to run the government on the land of black Tamil race, Semitic race and Semitic black race. Remember, common people should unite and end settlers policy, Varnadharam, Manu and Brahminism, which gives elites rights to exploit common people and women. They should also end hypocrites among the native who support settlers policies. Remember, first Antichrist is Cain. Coming of Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal, refers to Aryan settlers who are the children of Cain and their one-eyed policies. All priestly religions was created by Aryan settlers. By DNA, they are children of Cain, who is the first Antichrist. Muslim world is now being ruled by Aryan settlers. They are the Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal. Native black Tamil and mixed race following any of the priestly cult and Muslim cult, Shia, Sufi, Sunni, Wahhabi are all supporters of settlers, the Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal, the policies of Varnadharam. Asivagam is not based on priestly cult. It is based on elected minister where common people take active part in administration at Koil. Koil means house of a king, a parliament. Short Salah, namaz based on Burak hadith is a mockery to Prophet Muhammad, Angel Gibril and Allah's way of life called Asivagam. Remember, meditation was eliminated by Aryan Brahmins who slowly introduced idol for concentration, while Aryan Persian Bukhari introduced Burak hadith which eliminated yoga. The purpose of yoga meditation is to activate the Kundalini chakra and get connected to higher conscious. For doing this, you don't need any priestly cult. Gautam Buddha, who from royal bloodline of Seth Alais Tamil Shiva, said no human can give moksha or salvation. Real Muslims should beware of the Muslim organization who are working as slave of Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal, Aryan settlers who now hiding behind Muslim label. Aryavarta agenda is an Aryan settlers agenda who hiding behind Muslim world. Identify by race and tribe. Quran chapter 49 verse 13. Aryavarta means establishing rule of Aryan settlers and cave culture across non-Aryan races. Muslim in Arabic means one who submits to law of God. Submission to Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal, Aryan settlers does not make you a Muslim or believers. Beware of the Muslim next door, as they are blindly serving Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal, in other words, Aryan settlers. For some money, they have sold their soul to Satan. Please educate them, as they blindly follow hadith of Aryan settlers. Quran, which is the final reminder for Asivagam. Finally, do remember, the final war took place between Prophet Muhammad was against the Roman, Persian, Aryan settlers who now hiding behind Muslim label. Grandson of Prophet Muhammad, Hazrat Hussain, killed by the same Aryans who now hiding behind Muslim label. There are two versions of Islam. One version of Islam is from Prophet Adam to Prophet Muhammad. They all followed the way of life of Tamil Shiva, Quran chapter 42 verse 13. Other version of Islam is run by Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian, now hiding behind Muslim label. They run their Islam based on Varnadharam principle, Manu and priestly cult. Aryan settler version of Islam is followed by Shia, Sufi, Sunni, Wahhabi and other cults under Muslim label. So which version of Islam are you following? It's time one should decide whether you are going to follow the policies of the invaders or you are going to follow the way of prophets who followed the way of life of first Siddha, Tamil Shiva, whom Allah taught by a pen, giving him information on all subjects.
Vanakkam. Thank you.